Hey guys, welcome back to Iambraidgirl, and today I'm going to be showing you how to curl your hair. If you don't know how to already, it's okay, I totally understand. But the sad part is, I have a curling iron and I have a wand. Sad part is, I don't know the measurements for this wand, because it gets gradually smaller, so I guess I shouldn't be doing a tutorial on it if I don't know. Oh well. Anyways, I'm going to be showing you how to do it with either one of these. If you only have one or the other, make sure you subscribe, and let's get started. Okay, to start off, by the way, this is my totally natural hair. I haven't done anything to it except heat protectant. I do that right after I get out of the shower, and then I'm going to start curling my hair. So I'm going to take a piece from the section or from the front of your head. On one of them, I'm going to show you how to do it with the curling iron, the other with the wand. Then I'm going to split this into two pieces. Also, I don't curl my hair in layers. I know a lot of you do that, but for me, it doesn't really turn out that well. So I just curl it. I don't know. I'll show you guys. I split it off into two sections. I'm going to pin on this one. I'm going to start with the wand first. Once again, I don't know the measurements, so I'm sorry. Probably 1 inch, I don't know. So you're going to take it. You want to wrap it around while twisting the hair, wrapping it around the wand. And you want to leave the ends straight. I mean, you can if you want them curly, but for me, I like to keep them straight, kind of loosen it up. Also, you can hold it against your head, but for this, I'm just going to let them hang because I want them to be kind of loose curls. I don't want them to be super tight. I'm going to take my curling iron. I'm going to also show you how to make it easier. You don't have to like clamp it. So you're going to take it. You're going to do the exact same thing we did with the wand. You want to twist it and wrap it around. And then leave the ends off. So just hold it there. You see that there's a big difference. The wand gives you more of a curl and this just gives you like a wave. So you guys decide which one you like better. So just take another section. I'm going to take my wand and wrap it around while twisting your hair. And then kind of loosen it up and let it fall. And then I'm going to take the pieces from beneath, wrap it around. And you may notice that I'm not using a glove. I prefer not to, which greatens my chance of getting burnt, but I get burnt a lot sometimes. But I don't like using the glove because it's harder to grab a section of hair. But if you're just starting out with a wand, I would recommend using the glove. Okay, so this is a little different on this piece. To make my curls not all mushed together, I'm going to take this piece, instead of wrapping it around, I'm going to wrap it the opposite direction. This just kind of separates the curls and makes them a little bit more like beach waves, I guess you could say. And then just release it. And you want to keep grabbing more sections until you get to the other side of your head. Also, I forgot to tell you is I curl one direction and then on the next curl I curl the other direction. So every other one I switch off on every single one to just make it more separated. I don't know. Another thing is you can go back and you can take these front sections if you didn't like how they curled. If this isn't tight enough for you, you can just take it. You don't even have to curl all the way to the bottom because you see how it gets more curly at the bottom. You just can take it and just curl the front. Okay, another part I forgot to tell you is when you're curling your hair, you always, for the front pieces near your face, all the way probably until about here, you always want to curl away from your face. So what that means is you don't want it to be going towards you. See how it's going towards? You want the curl to be going away. So you twist, you wrap around. And that just kind of makes it not always in your face constantly. It's just kind of, you can sweep back if you're a beginner for curling your hair. Okay, now you see that I've curled about half of my hair. So I'm just gonna leave these pieces here. You can even take a clip and kind of section them off. On this side of my head, it's a little bit more tricky. I have a different part maybe than some of you guys, so it might be different for you. But to throw this behind your back, this is over your side, throw this behind your back. And then you're gonna take your wand and you are going to, without burning your neck, wrap it around the wand. Leaving the ends out. And you're gonna take another section of the wand. I'm gonna curl this one the opposite direction. And loosen it up and let it fall. It works for me. You guys might find a different way that it works for you, but I hope this is helpful to you somewhat. You see that I have my last section near my face. Once again, I'm going to take it, wrap the hair away from your face, twist it if you can, and then leave the end out. And there you go. You can go back, take sections that you don't really like how they look, and then just recurl them. And then take your clip out, take your hair, grab it, and flip your head. And what I like to do is, you see how the curls kind of fall? There's not much like volume near the roots of your head. Barely take a section from up there. I like to take it and curl it really close to my head, like this, and kind of release it. See how it kind of, it's more, a little bit more volume up there? And I just do that all around my whole head. And then take your curls, lift it, and hairspray it. And then you're finished. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you found this tutorial useful. Make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you next week. Bye!